22. Before we do that, little things that I notice. I want to talk about the economy for just 2-3 minutes for 2022, because I think that's important. Everybody can hear me okay?
Thank you.
Yes.
You know,
you can listen to the experts and all the pontificators and all the Nostradamuses out there, but I look for clues. I look for little clues. I go to the supermarket. I like Perugino and what's the other bubbly water? Perrier. I drink this in black coffee. We're going to do a health class, by the way. Jessica gave me that idea. I want to talk about health, and I want you, Jessica, there. Health class. I want everybody to live long and prosper. What was that?
That's a wonderful idea.
Rock. You can do that. Look at you guys can all do that. Wow. Little clues. Every time I go to the store, this goes up in price by a few pennies. It's really amazing. It used to be cheap, overpriced Italian bubble water. Now it's getting obnoxiously priced. It's getting close to what beer cost. It's only water. Okay. Have you noticed? I was going to get a new iPad. Apple sent me an offer. They wanted to take my very, very old iPad and give me $205 for a used iPad mini. And I said, wow, that's a lot of money. It's almost what I paid for it 3, 4, 5 years ago. And I went online. I was going to order a new one because they were going to give me a credit. Guess what the delivery date is for a new iPad mini?
March.
Seven to 10 weeks.
Wow.
Something's wrong out there when Apple cannot get products in. I need a new car. My lease was out about 6-7 months ago. I extended it because there's no cars available. There was no cars available right then. Guess what's available now?
It's China.
I was talking to my dealer. I've bought, I don't know, 12, 13 leased cars from this one dealer. They told me at least a month before they get in a model that I like. A month. This is America. We're based on producing things and buying, making people spend more money than they have and things like that. Somebody give me some feedback. What is going on here that products are not available?
It's China.
Chip shortages.
It's the U.S. Mint's been having the same problem all of 2021. It's one per household. No matter who you are, you get one coin per household. And even at the 2022 Eagles, long wait.
Okay. Why? What's going on with our production? Is this all because of COVID? What is going on? I heard something about China's charging a lot more for those. What are those things that hold products on the boats? Those big boxes that are on the back of 18-wheelers? What do you call them?
Freight containers.
Thank you. Freight containers. I heard freight containers have gone up enormously in price and things like that. Is this going to affect us going into, is it affecting us now? And is it going to get worse in 2022?
Yes.
We're not even talking inflation and interest rates. Mm. We're just talking supplying now. Mm. Things like that. I mean,
the airlines are all backed up right now too. It's hard to fly right now because people aren't turning up for work.
Yeah, they cancel in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
What is this? Is this all COVID related or what's going on? Is it going to get worse? I think it could get worse in the 2022 before it gets better. How do we prepare for it? How do we deal with it? Most of us are in real estate. How is this going to affect our real estate businesses?
People are going to need to sell.
What do you mean? Elaborate, Alex.
People need money, and a lot of people are falling behind. A lot of people aren't going to qualify for their forbearances. A lot of people are running into issues with affording things and getting things, and things are on hold for them as well. So I think people are going to be in a position where they need to cash out.
You think they're going to run up credit?
Oh, yeah.
That's a good point.
Credit. John Andrus, you've got to jump. You're my banker. You've got to jump in here, John. You've got to jump. Give us your wisdom here, John.
Let me unmute myself. I wish I knew. It's certainly not like 2008 by any stretch of the imagination. I can't figure out, and this is nothing from the banking industry, I can't figure out, you know, when when's this all going to happen? All these forbearances, and then you got the commercial guy. It's such a ripple, a domino effect. I don't know how it's going to manifest itself. I don't know how it can work out. I mean, people that had their mortgages or their rents forbeared, they've spent that money. I mean, they don't have it, you know. So obviously, a lot of them been added to the back of the mortgages. But wow, I wish I knew. I take advantage of it.
How about the flow of money? Is if people can't want to buy things, but can't afford to buy things, and companies can't manufacture these things, the flow of money through our society, through our system here, how's that going to affect us going into 2022?
I think America's in a lot of debt. The debt is overwhelming.
Yeah. We've always been in debt. We've always been crazy in debt.
So you don't think it's kind of catching up? We're kind of not in inflation, but deflation? You don't think deflation may have a lot to do with some of it?
We print too much money. $7-8 trillion. Somebody help me. It's almost meaningless saying these numbers. We've spent more money this year going from last year due to COVID and a lot of other reasons. A lot of crazy politicians. Oop, I gave an opinion. Shit. Sorry. we're spending more money than we're taking in, and that raises our national debt. For those of you old enough to remember Ronald Reagan, and things like that, we're seeing interest rates go up. We're seeing the price of normal goods go up. Companies, I want to buy a car. I want to buy a computer. It's not available to me right now. All these things. They're cumulative. I see going into the, I think Alex is right. This has got to have an effect on real estate. Real estate is not immune to all these things going on at the same time. There's too many different little things going on at the same time that I've never noticed before. In 2008, it was a banking crisis. That was one thing. They fixed it. Slow recovery. Everything went back to normal for all the way up to 2022, as far as real estate's concerned. But now we've got all these other little factors. It's a hybrid of a lot of stuff. Anybody else? Opinion time.
I think we're going to get more homeless people, sadly. There's going to be more homeless people. People will double up in, like, instead of one person renting a two-bedroom, there'll be two people renting a one-bedroom apartment. Things like that are going to happen.
How about real estate? Yeah, Ben, real estate. If people can't afford to buy homes, I mean, they're very unaffordable to a great deal of people now. Interest rates go up. Inflation makes properties go up. Nobody's buying anything. What happens? Price is going to come down.
They will come down some. We're going to see all kinds of exotic arrangements. There are three young women who just bought a home together, and they have no paperwork in terms of what the exit plan is. They have some, friend understandings about it's, we'll see how that arrangement works out.
That's a disaster waiting to happen.
Or an opportunity to stay in touch with them and help them somehow.
Yeah, they need some contracts.
I think the big investors are going to buy up a lot of real estate. There's going to be more rentals.
What does Warren Buffett do every time there's this kind of economic turmoil? What does Warren Buffett do?
Buys.
Why?
When things are down, he...
Contrarian.
Where do you get your...
He's a contrarian.
Buys. What does he buy? What going into 2022, let's just assume for a moment there's going to be a slowdown. Interest rates are going to be going up. People are not going to buy cars, take vacations. Real estate is going to start dipping a little, adjusting a little. It has to eventually. Where's the opportunities for us?
Lease options.
You can't
buy and hold.
Creative financing.
Traditionally, Ben's right, gold and precious metals. When people get worried, they go back to basics, don't they?
They are. Yeah.
All
and
the
buy
metals.
And hold your real estate. Buying low and rent and hold.
Now you can't just say real estate. You can't just say lease purchase. What kind of real estate? Where are you going to buy it? How are you going to buy it?
Probably single family, no?
Yeah,
I was, I love large single family. I agree, Alex. I think single family homes are the safest and long-term investment you'll ever make. But what about the location? What properties, what areas tend to recover the fastest and go up the fastest when the economy's healthy?
Median home prices that are around the salary, 3 to 4 times the salary in that area.
Solid neighborhoods, upscale neighborhoods, good school districts, very low crime areas. Mm-hmm. Are we seeing, do you think this, there's, you know, you got to watch your stats. What's going on with crime in certain cities right now?
Soaring.
It's going up.
Yeah.
It's going up. What happens? What do people do who can afford to move?
They get out of there.
And where do they go?
The suburbs, further out.
Yeah. Or rural areas. Yeah. Are we seeing an influence? Kevin Hollander, speak up. Hit your button.
Yeah, so I agree with everybody in terms of, you know, the
agree with everybody, but we all just we everybody.
Hey, you know, I got to play the middle ground. Anyway,
no, be dangerous. Be dangerous. Have an opinion. Opinions are welcome here, even if we don't agree.
In the markets that we've been working in, Indiana, Michigan, and Ohio, but two in particular, Detroit Metro and Anderson, Indiana, the investors, the buyers, if you will, the buy and holders, the fix and flippers, they really like the idea of grabbing those deals in the, what we're finding anyway, and where we're taking advantage of, they're wanting to go into those neighborhoods that do need the help. They do need that rehab and bring them back. So we're experiencing some good things there. Unfortunately, what that means is we have to work and do what we can creatively to acquire the properties, to wholesale them out to what the buyers are willing to spend. So as long as we understand those buy boxes, you know, we're on the good side of that.
Is creative real estate better when we're in this quandary that we're going into right now, this inflation and worrying? Is it easier to do that, all that wonderful creative real estate lease purchase and subject to and owner finance when people get worried?
I mean, what we're finding is that it is, but it also takes a longer conversation for people to feel comfortable to move forward. And you're not always going to hit all of the check all the boxes, if you will, and you're not going to win every conversation. But at the same time, it is easier because if you're bringing that solution to the table, they're more apt to entertain it, consider it, and help you get across the finish line because it's to their advantage.
So going into 2022, knowing or reasonably assuming that the economy is going to slow down, that prices are going to, and interest rates are going to go up, that who knows, what's the next pandemic after Omicron? What's the next one, you know, and everything.
Star Trek-a-con.
Vulcan-con.
Vulcan-con. I have a good prediction and a recommendation for people who are interested in going a new avenue. Is things like tiny homes, invest in tiny homes. You know what tiny homes are?
Yes,
and mobile homes.
Mobile homes. Yeah.
Mobile homes and tiny homes, I think, are going to be the new wave.
They've been talking about that. They've been talking about tiny homes for a long time. Certain places, I know in California, Palm Springs, there are now tiny home sections. Mm-hmm. Little log cabins, kind of little things with lofts for the bedroom, little living rooms. But certain communities don't like it. California has had a change of law where actually you can now build adjacent homes on your property. Mm-hmm. David, help me out. What's it called? It was a new law.
ADUs.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Just being able to put an additional dwelling unit that has plumbing, electrical, pretty much most of the rough ends, and you can capitalize on that and rent it out or add value for a fix and flip and just allow for more housing.
Yeah. And California has changed their laws, made it very easy. People converting garages,
mm-hmm.
into rental places and everything. So they, it's one of the smart, California doesn't do that many smart things, but I thought that was a pretty good idea, actually.
Do we I don't even think they're charging for the permits right now. For
Alex, do we have that in Colorado?
ADUs? Yeah, yeah. They just passed that in one of my rentals in Aurora. They're doing it all across metros, all across the U.S. So when you're looking at properties, look at the zoning too. Just don't wholesale them off. Look at the zoning. Get familiar with zoning. That'll make you an extra $5,000 or $10,000 on a lot of your deals.
I want to get a speaker on ADUs here in the going into next year. Jessica.